everyone. Today we're going to unbox the MI Home Security Camera 360 degrees with a 1080p resolution. Let's unbox and take a look what's inside of the box. Once we open the box, it has three items inside. First, there's a user manual and a 2-meter USB micro USB cable to use as a power supply to your camera. Note that the MI didn't include a power socket for this device, so you can use any 5V charger. Let's take a look inside of the main camera parts. It has a LED status indicator on the upper front face, the camera lens, the microphone for two-way communication. You have to tilt up the camera to access the micro SD card slot. Note that this device only supports up to 64GB of size only. I will link in the description below which memory card that I use on this camera. At the back side of the camera, there's a loudspeaker. At the bottom part, there's a micro USB charging port. And lastly, a reset button. For the application installation, you can download the MI Home app on both Android and iOS. After the application installation, you have to register your own account. Then after that, we can start pairing the device to your mobile phone using the MI Home application. Once you open the application, you have to tap the upper right corner of the screen with the plus button to add the device. And after that, you can select the camera and choose the MI Home Security Camera 360. Now on your device, locate the reset button. Press and hold within 3 seconds and then wait for the device prompt that the reset has been completed. Select your Wi-Fi connection. In this part, this device supports only 2.4 GHz, so keep that in mind. Face your mobile phone QR codes towards the MI camera until you hear the pair successfully. After that, you can hear connected to Wi-Fi successfully. You can select your desired camera location in this section. And also, you have the option to rename your camera. As you can see, I have two cameras paired on this device which you can arrange and view simultaneously. You can pan your camera to the left and right and tilt up and down. Inside the settings, in the camera settings, you have the option to change your camera settings. You can switch the status light on and off. For the data usage warning, is only applicable when you're using the data to prevent unwanted data usage. Inside the sleep settings, you can switch on and off or create a schedule when you want to put asleep your camera. In image settings, watermark on and off to allow you to identify which time and date stamp on your image, which I prefer to keep it on all the time. It also allows you to correct your lens distortion. In a wide dynamic range mode, it gives flexibility on your camera exposure, especially in shadow and highlights. You can also rotate the orientation of your image. For the home monitoring should be always on in monitoring time. You have the option to keep it on for 24 hours, daytime, or nighttime. At the last option is to create your own schedule. Alert sensitivity, you have to select between detect motion or alert only when it has a large movement within the area. In the time interval, you have the option to select the notification between times, from 3 minutes up to every 30 minutes. Event notification, motion detect, or person detect. When we go to storage settings, in storage settings, you can format, mount, unmount, or view your memory card status. And lastly, the recording time settings. But for me, I preferred only when the motion detect to save some space in your memory card. It also allows you to add your NAS storage if you have. In network settings, you can check your Wi-Fi name, signal quality, IP address, and MAC addresses. Under the general settings, you can change your device name, location, check the firmware updates, and other security settings. You can also create your automation on this application. So that's all for today's video, guys. If you have any question, please let me know in the comment section below. Are you using one of these or looking for this camera? I will leave the link in the description below so you can check by yourself. Once again, thank you for watching and see you in the next video.